السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، tonight Saturday the 11th of Jumada الأول 1437 matching the 20th of February 2016 and the second part of our session is the 50 hadith by al-Imam Ibn Rajab, and today we are doing the hadith number 12 عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من حسن إسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعنيه. حديث حسن رواه الترمذي وغيره. This hadith from أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, from the good Islam, from the perfect Islam, يعني one practicing Islam, one being truly a Muslim, from the good Islam of a person is him leaving that which does not concern him. Part of the good Islam, يعني the good practice of the religion of Islam of a person, is him leaving that which does not concern him. This hadith, he says, هذا الحديث أصل عظيم من أصول الأدب. This hadith is a great principle, a great foundation of the foundations of adab, etiquettes, manners. قال أبو محمد ابن أبي زيد إمام المالكية في زمانه. إمام أبو محمد ابن أبي زيد, the Imam, the leaders of the مالكية, the Maliki scholars of his time. The author of the book الرسالة, which is translated into English, starts with the Aqidah, the beliefs of Ahlul Sunnah. Then he mentions the rulings according to the Maliki Madhab. He's a famous Imam. And Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala facilitated for us to go through his belief, his Aqidah, with the explanation of the Shaykh Abdul Muhsin Al-Abbad, Hafizahullah ta'ala. We did that in Jami Mosque. And the lectures are all recorded and they are, you know, accessible through the website, alhamdulillah ta'ala. This great Imam Ibn Abi Zayd, he said, جِمَاعُ آدَابِ الْخَيْرِ وَأَزِمَّتُهُ, that what gathers together adab. Adab is one. Etiquette, adab, etiquettes, right? What gathers together for you the adab, etiquettes, وَأَزِمَّتُ, what holds it together. Zimam is like a rope. Azimma is the plural. So you have an animal, you pull it with the zimam. And in the hadith, which you've heard a few times, جواب الكافي, and other than that, that the fire, Jahannam, is brought, right, is dragged, right, with 70,000 ropes, right, by 70,000 angels dragging it. Zimam, the word zimam there is shows up. Here he says what gathers together etiquettes and holds it down for you, right? تتفرع من أربعة أحاديث. They branch off four أحاديث. So if you want manners, you want adab, etiquettes, you have four أحاديث that gather together for you manners, etiquettes. He said, قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. The one who believes in Allah and the last day, let him say good, khayran, or let him remain quiet, أو ليصمت. Right? This is a very famous hadith. It shows the danger of the tongue. But you want to know the manners, this hadith is one of them. Be careful about your tongue. There is actually one very short hadith, three-word hadith. It's a good advice for those who continue. Right? It says, man, whoever, samata, was quiet, naja, is saved. Three words. Man samata naja. The one who keeps quiet, he's saved. Right? Man samata naja. Three words only. Right? And this hadith, if you believe in Allah and at the last day, you say that which is good or remain quiet. That's one quarter of the foundations of al-adab. وقوله صلى الله عليه وسلم من حسن إسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعنيه. This our hadith of today. Part of the good Islam of a person is him leaving that which does not concern him. وقوله للذي اختصر له في الوصية. Also his statement عليه الصلاة والسلام to the one whom he shortened, whom he made a summary of advice, of a counsel. And a man came and he wants an advice, and he wants it to be short. So he gave him, alayhi salatu wasalam, a very short piece of advice. Two words. La, do not, taghdab, get angry. La taghdab, do not get angry. Right? Do not get angry. This is the third hadith where it's the third pillar or the third foundation around which adab revolves, etiquettes. The fourth one, قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم, المؤمن يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. The believer loves for his brother that which he loves for himself. Those four ahadith, around them revolve the etiquettes in al-Islam. شرح الحديث. Now explaining this hadith. That was the words of al-Imam ibn Abi Zayd. Right? Abu Muhammad ibn Abi Zayd, the leader of the Malikis of his time. He said that those four ahadith, they are foundations for the etiquettes. From them, all kinds of manners, all kinds of etiquettes, they branch of these ahadith. شرح الحديث, explanation of the hadith. معنى هذا الحديث, the meaning of this hadith, أن من حسن إسلامه ترك ما لا يعنيه من قول وفعل. That part of his Islam being good, right, is him leaving that which does not concern him of a statement or action, and action. واقتصر على ما يعنيه من الأقوال والأفعال. And he restricts himself to that which concern him, to that which concerns him, of statements and actions. He says, وليس المراد, it is not intended, ليس المراد أن يترك أنه يترك ما لا عناية له به ولا إرادة بحكم الهوى وطلب النفس. The meaning of this hadith is not that he leaves what he is not concerned with and what he does not want, he does not wish, by the ruling of desire, by the control of his desires over him, and the request of his own self, by the longing and yearning of his own self. This is not what is meant. Rather, بل بحكم الشرع والإسلام. Rather, through the judgment, through the ruling of the legislation and Islam. Right? So someone, oh, I don't like this, so it does not concern me, I'm not doing it. It's not like that. It's not what you like and what you don't like, what you feel like doing and what you do not feel like doing. You leave what does not concern you as Islam judged that these things should not concern you. Not what you yourself or your desires judge that these things do not concern you, right? He says, وَلِهَذَا جَعَلَهُ مِنْ حُسْنِ الْإِسْلَامِ. This is why he made this from the good Islam. فَإِذَا حَسُنَ إِسْلَامُ الْمَرْءِ تَرَكَ مَا لَا يَعْنِي. If the Islam of a person, this submission to Allah, was good, then he would leave what does not concern him in Islam of مِنَ الْأَقْوَالِ وَالْأَفْعَالِ, from statements and actions. فَإِنَّ الْإِسْلَامِ يَقْتَضِي فِعْلَ الْوَاجِبَاتِ. For accepting Islam, this necessitates doing things that are obligatory. وَإِنَّ الْإِسْلَامَ الْكَامِلَ الْمَمْدُوحِ. Islam that is complete, that is praiseworthy, يَدْخُلُ فِيهِ تَرْكُ الْمُحَرَّمَاتِ. Included in it is to leave prohibitions. كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. The Muslim is the one from whom the Muslims are safe from his tongue and his hand. وإذا حسن الإسلام, if the submission of a person, if the Islam of a person becomes good, becomes perfect, اقتضى ترك ما لا يعني كله من المحرمات. This necessitates that one would leave, would abandon all that does not concern him of prohibitions. والمشتبهات, things that are doubtful. والمكروهات, and things that are disliked legally, is disliked. وفضول المباحات, and the extra of allowable things, التي لا يحتاج إليها, which he does not need. فإن هذا كله لا يعني المسلم. For all of that does not concern the Muslim. إذا كمل إسلامه, if his Islam became perfect. وبلغ إلى درجة الإحسان, his Islam became good and reach even the degree of إحسان, which is perfection in everything. وهو أن يعبد الله تعالى كأنه يراه. إحسان, and that is to worship Allah تعالى as though he sees him. فإن لم يكن يراه فإن الله يراه. For surely if he does not see him, truly Allah sees him. فمن عبد الله على استحضار قربه ومشاهدته بقلبه. So the one who worships Allah along with calling to mind his closeness, calling to mind that he sees Allah with his heart, he's witnessing Allah with his heart, or أو على استحضار قرب الله منه واطلاعه عليه, or he worships Allah calling to mind the closeness of Allah to him and Allah actually watching him, looking at him. فَقَدْ حَسُنَ إِسْلَامُهُ. Then his Islam became perfect or becomes perfect. وَلَزِمَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ, and this necessitates أَنْ يَتْرُكَ كُلَّ مَا لَا يَعْنِي, and that necessitates that he should abandon, that he should leave everything that does not concern him in Islam. كُلَّ مَا لَا يَعْنِيهِ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ. وَيَشْتَغِلَ بِمَا يَعْنِيهِ فِيهِ, and that he gets busying himself, that he busies himself with that which concerns him in it, with that which concerns him in Islam. He says, فَإِنَّهُ يَتَوَلَّدُ مِنْ هَذَيْنِ الْمَقَامَيْنِ الْإِسْتِحْيَاءُ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَتَرْكُ كُلِّ مَا يُسْتَحْيَ مِنْهِ. These two stations in al-ihsan. Ihsan, we have Islam, Iman, Ihsan, right? Ihsan, this perfection of worshipping Allah, it has two levels. This has passed before. but it's always good to remind, right? أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه, that you worship Allah as though you see him. This is the station, right? That you worship Allah, calling to mind that Allah is close to you and you are watching him, looking at him with your heart, right? We say looking at him with your heart because we know no one will see Allah in this worldly life, right? But the hadith says كَأَنَّهُ يَرَاهُ أَن تَعْبُدَ اللَّهُ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ, that you worship Allah as if you see him, as though you see him. You see him here by the heart, right? Right? This is the maqam of al-mushahada. If you remember the higher one, mushahada. You are witnessing Allah, seeing him. فَإِن لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكُ. So if you do not see him, surely he does see you. This is now a lower level, right? If you cannot achieve that level of you watching, you witnessing Allah, then you worship him, calling to mind his closeness to you and the fact that he sees you, right? He says these two positions, these two stations, maqam main, maqamain, they bring about, yatawallad, they bring about, walad, you know walad, right? Child, beget, lam yalid wa lam yulad, right? About Allah, Allahu samad, lam yalid wa lam yulad, right? He does not beget nor was he begotten, right? يتولد, this is the verb now. The results from that, right? These two stations, يتولد من هذين المقامين. The results, there comes about from these two stations, مقامين, مقام واحد, مقامين, two, right? These two stations, الاستحياء, shyness, right? Shyness from Allah. And leaving everything, يُسْتَحْيَى مِنْهُ, leaving anything that you are shy from, right? قَالَ بَعْضُهُمْ, some have said, استحيي من الله, be shy of Allah, على قدر قربه منك, be shy of Allah, how much should you be shy? The amount of how close he is to you, right? استحي من الله على قدر قربه منك, be shy of Allah, the amount or as much as he's close to you. How close he is? He's very close, right? طيب, وخفي الله على قدر قدرته عليك, be afraid of Allah according to how much he has ability over you, right? How much ability he has. He is all able, right? So be shy from him as much as he is close to you. Well, he is very close, so you need to be really shy, right? And be afraid of him as much as the power and ability he has over you. Well, he has so much power that you cannot stand, right? So you, it means you'll be so afraid of him, right? وَقَالَ بَعْضُ الْعَارِفِينَ, and some of those who truly know Allah, they said, إِذَا تَكَلَّمْتَ فَذْكُرْ سَمْعَ اللَّهِ لَكَ. If you speak, إِذَا تَكَلَّمْتَ, if you speak, فَذْكُرْ, then remember, سَمْعَ اللَّهِ لَكَ, that Allah hears you, the hearing of Allah, سَمْعَ اللَّهِ, that Allah is actually hearing you. وَإِذَا سَكَتَّ, and if you are silent, you become quiet, فَذْكُرْ نَظَرَهُ إِلَيْكَ, then remember the fact that he is looking at you. وَقَالَ الْحَسَنُ, الْحَسَنُ said, رحمه الله, مِنْ عَلَامَةِ إِعْرَادِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى عَنِ الْعَبْدِ أن يجعل شغله فيما لا يعنيه. From the sign of Allah abandoning, turning away from the servant, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to make him busy, to make his business be what occupies him, be that which does not concern him. Right? This is a sign, wal'iyadu billah, that Allah let that person down. He just turned away from him. Right? Allah turns to those who turn to him. There's this famous hadith which Rasulullah was speaking in the masjid, and there were three people that came in. I'm sure most of you know this hadith. So one of them, he got closer, found a spot, he sat in it. The second one, he was shy at the back, so he just sat at the end of the circle. The third one, he just walked away. So Rasulullah said about the first one, right? He turned to Allah, so Allah turned to him. The second one, he was shy, so Allah was shy with him. As for the third one, he turned away, so Allah turned away from him. Right? Everyone got the reward from the same action that they have done. Right? So here he says, من علامة إعراض الله تعالى عن العبد, from the signs of Allah abandoning and turning away from the servant, is to make him busy with that which does not concern him. يعني, you find someone talking about that organization and that mosque and that, and then what are you doing? Like, what have you done? What have you achieved today? What kind of dhikr? What kind of Quran? What about your salah? And you find him busy with that over these, then you know Allah, he turned away from this person. Although they might think that they are so much, you know, watching the others. He did this, he came, he didn't come. You know, he has his own, you know, yani, who did what and who didn't do what, right? So those, if they are busy with things that do not concern him, concern them, then they should know that Allah let them down. Allah turned away from them. وقال سهل بن عبد الله التستري, سهل بن عبد الله التستري said, من تكلم فيما لا يعنيه حرم الصدق. The one who speaks in that which does not concern him, or with that which does not concern him, he will be prevented, he will be deprived, حُرِمَ, he will be deprived, he will be prohibited from achieving truthfulness. وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. And it is true that many of those who talk about things that do not concern him, they end up, وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ, in telling lies. وقال معروف, معروف said, كلام العبد فيما لا يعنيه خذلان, could be خذلان too, have it in the book, they have it with the dhamma there, that the servant speaking in that which does not concern him, or with that does not concern him, this is a let down from Allah, يعني for that person. Allah failed him, Allah let him down, right? The fact that he is talking in things that should not concern him, do not concern him, right? Then this is a sign that Allah let him down. Then he speaks about the excellence of leaving that which do not concern you. He says that هذا الحديث, this hadith, يدل على أن ترك ما لا يعني المرء من حسن إسلامه. It proves that leaving that which does not concern the person is part of his perfect Islam, or part of perfecting his Islam. فإذا ترك ما لا يعني, if he left that which does not concern him, وفعل ما يعنيه كله, and he did all that concern him, فقد كمل حسن إسلامه, then the perfection of his deen, of his Islam, has been complete. Right? وقد جاءت الأحاديث بفضل من حسن إسلامه. The ahadith have come with the excellence of the one whom his Islam is good, whose Islam is perfect. وأنه تضاعف حسناته, that his good deeds are actually multiplied. وتكفر سيئاته, and that his evil deeds are washed away or erased, expiated for. والظاهر, and what appears or what is apparent, ظاهر, what is apparent is أن كثرة المضاعفة تكون بحسب حسن الإسلام, that the abundance of multiplication, the multiplication of the good deeds, they are multiplied according to the perfection of Islam. يعني the more your Islam is perfect, the more your good deeds are multiplied. The more your good deeds are multiplied. I think we will stop here, inshallah, and we will continue next week.